People in western parts of the state are waking up to a major mess after flash flooding created some big problems.
In Westmoreland, people were evacuated overnight due to the fast rising water there. We're told several roads have been washed out, and a section of Route 12 in the area of South Village Road is underwater. Ray Brewer joins us live in Westmoreland now with a closer look at what people are dealing with. And Ray, we look behind you, there's all kinds of damage everywhere out there.
Sean, and you can see one of the residents here trying to make their way carefully down Route 12 as well. This is a section that's been washed out. You can see these orange cones everywhere. It gives you an extent of the damage, and this is just one small section. Now, according to one of the residents we talked to, who was evacuated last night by payloader, the deluge happened at about 11 o'clock last night. That's when he says the heavens opened, and a little brook that is just east of here became a raging river, causing all this damage, even undermining some foundations in some case. The good news is that you can see the power is still on in this area, but there is a lot of cleanup. Now, the residents who were evacuated earlier in Westmoreland have been allowed to go back to their homes and begin the process of cleaning up. For these residents, this is an all too familiar situation. Last May, you may recall, they were dealing with 7 inches of rain in a short period of time. Now, just a little bit north of here in Walpole, the official tower of rainfall was a little over 2 1/3 inches of rain, but the residents here are telling us that they got a lot more than that, and there was some localized flooding. There's no estimate yet on any damage, but trying to get north from Keene area is virtually impossible. The DOT telling people that they have to go out to Brattleboro on Route 9 and then head north on 91. All the roads running north and south, 12, 12A, Route 63, have been washed out and closed. Reporting live in Westmoreland, Ray Brewer, WMUR News 9.